Welcome back. In the last video, we set up some visual effects like the character's speed and also his color changing. In this video, we're going to work on the batteries so that they shoot electricity from between them and the character when they're collected. If you remember, when we were first creating the battery pickups, we created a was collected event that was a blueprint native event. So let's go to take a look at that really quick. So actually, it was on the base pickup. We had was collected and then was collected implementation. And because this is a blueprint native event, we can have some behavior be set up in code, like the destroying the battery, and then we're going to set up some behavior that can be called in blueprints. So in the blueprint, we're going to go to our battery blueprint and go ahead and open that up. Oh, it's actually already open. And at this point, it's a data-only blueprint, but we need to add some script. So we're going to go ahead and add or click on Open Full Blueprint Editor. And there are some default events set up, but what we need is the was collected event. So let's right click and use the context menu to find was collected. And we're going to spawn an emitter based on this. So let's see, we're going to spawn emitter, and it's going to be attached. And we'll just go ahead and connect that to our was collected event. So when was collected is called in our collection function, the character, it will first come look for this blueprint event, fire it, and then when we add a call to the parent, it will also reach back and call any code that we've set up. We need to attach, actually, we're going to fill in our emitter template. And we've got this electricity arc that we imported from the constant examples previously. We're going to attach to component pickup mesh. So if you actually click on the pickup mesh here in the components tab and connect it directly to the attach to component pin, it will go ahead and wire itself up. We don't have a particular attach point, but we do want to snap to target, including scale, and leave auto destroy on. So this right now would just create our electricity and have it be sort of out in the world. But what we want it to do is actually connect between the battery and our character. What we need to do though is to actually go make a quick adjustment to our electricity. So we can actually use this right here to find it in the content browser. Let's go ahead and open it. Because when we exported it, it was great because it's got a lot of the lightning set up, but it's a little bright for what we want, and we also need to change the source. So first we'll change the source, which is here on the list of modules, and our source is going to be the emitter, and our target is going to be user set. So we'll save that, and then we will change the initial size. If you want to click on that module, expand that start size. Basically unfolding until we get, and 2 looks right for that, so we're good there. But for initial color, which is the next one down, we'll expand start color, distribution vector, that constant, and those are a little high, so we're going to take these down, basically divide them all by 100, so 0.5, and 1, and 2.5. And this is basically the only tweaking for now, but we'll come back and do more tweaking when we're doing the polish. The main things are to make sure that your source are set to emitter and your target is set to user set. Now we can go back to our blueprint and we need to have one end be on the character. So let's go ahead and get our character, get the player, right click, get the context menu, get player character. And this is using that same gameplay statics library that we've used before in code, actually. And then we need to get the mesh from that. And the mesh is actually defined on the character, so we don't need to cast specifically to our particular battery collector type. So we'll just get the mesh. Let's see. Yeah, get mesh. click on that. And then we're going to get a socket so that the electricity will connect to a particular bone on the skeletal mesh's skeleton. So get socket location. And let's figure out which socket we want to use. So I think I still have the character blueprint open here. And I can click on the mesh and then the skeletal mesh. And I click on the skeleton mode here. And I can see a whole list of bones or sockets here on the left side. And what I want is something sort of in the chest, so it hits them in the logo. Spine 02 looks like what I want. So spine 02, copy selected bone name. You can just right click on the name there in the list and copy selected bone name. And then right here, paste. So now it's specifically the right formatting. So I don't worry about any typos or anything like that. So taking the returned spawn emitter, I want to drag off that pin and set beam target point. And then connect that target point to the socket location. So it'll always target the chest of our character. Then once that's done, we actually want this to update frequently. So if I'm running around, the electricity will follow the character. And to do that, we need a sequence node. A sequence node is pretty nice because you could wire everything up together in one long row, but say you wanted to split off and only have one section repeat, or you really just wanted to line up, you know, it's more for the organization of your blueprint and keeping things really, really clear. So first, we're going to add a delay. And we're going to use a delay and not a retriggerable delay, because if it gets called again, we don't want it to basically restart the delay. And we'll set this to 1 second. And when that's done, we're actually going to call to the parent, which, if you remember, is going to destroy the battery. To do that, right-click on Event Was Collected, and add a call to the parent function. And then just drag this over to the right, and wire it up here to our delay. And then we want another delay, so we can copy this. Although we're actually going to put this more as 0.1. And after we do a delay and a call to the parents, we will sort of loop back through and keep updating our beam target point. So let me just add a reroute node here. And sort of drag that down so I can clean up our wires a little bit. Okay, so basically the whole execution of the graph will be that an emitter is spawned. It will set the target point to be our character's spine. It will delay for 1 second and then call the parent function and destroy the battery. And then it will keep delaying and going back and resetting the beam target point, so it'll follow the character around. So we can go ahead and compile and save the blueprint and test this out. The lighting may be a little bit off on this. Like I said, I haven't tweaked that part yet, but we should be able to at least see the lightning effect. So the batteries are spawning in, and if I collect them, they're spawning electricity that will follow my character around. And again, I will want to tweak the size of that in the polish section of the tutorial, but for now, I can see that as I run around, the electricity follows my character, it hits in that sort of spine the way I wanted to, and generally success. So tune back in for the next video. We're going to start setting up the winning and losing states. Thanks.